Hey everyone, this is Nick, and today I'm going to show you a few different ways that you can make fun, engaging, and quick waffle charts right inside of PowerPoint. Now, these aren't going to be updatable charts, so you're not going to be able to sort of enter into a cell a percentage and then have the waffle chart update, but sometimes good enough is just good enough. So we're going to go for method number one, and that is just brute force squares. So inside your PowerPoint slide, we are going to insert a rectangle. I'm going to make sure that this is an exact square. And I actually want this to be a little bit lower. So I'm going to say it's 0.5 by 0.5 inches. And what I'm going to do now is push Control D to duplicate the square. I'm going to drag it into place. Say that this is a pretty good length. Now when I push Control D again, it's going to move, it's going to duplicate a square in the exact same location, but just a little further to the right. So let's say Control D. There's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now here's one of my rows. Now for the rest of the waffle chart, I need 10 more rows, or I need 10 rows of these columns. So I'm gonna actually push Control G to group this. I'm gonna push Control D to duplicate the entire group. I'm gonna put that in exact position there. Now push Control D again. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Perfect waffle chart. Now if I wanted to recolor this, I'm gonna have to ungroup everything. So I'm gonna highlight the entire thing, push Control Shift G to ungroup. And now what I can do is say I want 30% of the squares, or say I want all the squares to be highlighted in gray as the base. We're gonna go ahead and shape fill that. And then maybe I want these bottom three rows to be filled in with the color. 30%, a nice 30% waffle square. Now, if I didn't want those blue outlines around each of the squares, I'm just gonna highlight everything. Go up to that format shape dialog menu, and then outline, and then no outline. We have a beautiful waffle chart there. Now, if you have the free Bright Slide PowerPoint add-in by the company called Bright Carbon, you can actually make waffle charts really quickly using their split and align tools. So here I made a chart in the exact height and width that I want my waffle chart to take up. I'm gonna highlight the box, it's just a rectangle shape. I'm gonna go up to the Bright Slide tab, we're gonna click on split and align, and you can see that I already have it set to 10 columns and 10 rows, and so I have a beautiful waffle chart right there. And the same thing, I could update the colors of each of those shapes just to the color that I want to match. Maybe there's a couple other ones here. Maybe it's like 53%, and we're just going to shape fill that beautiful waffle chart. It doesn't just work on shapes, it also works on graphics and pictures. So you could also do an icon like this. This is just an icon right from PowerPoint. I colored it gray, and make sure that it's the size that you want to take up for your waffle chart, your height and your width. So we're just going to go ahead and click on the graphic, go up to the Bright Slide add-in, click on split and align. It's already set to 10 by 10. And so there you can see that I have a nice waffle chart here of 10 by 10 people. I can also go ahead and do the exact same thing to update the colors of each of these graphics, since they're scalable vector formats, those icons. Let's go ahead and just color that. Maybe I want to have more than two or more than one category represented here. So perhaps I might color these different colors. And you can see how this might work in your own slide. So super cool, easy waffle chart. That is method number one, the brute force boxes, and kind of 1.1, 1.5 by Bright Slide. The split and align tool is super, super easy. All right, our method number two is a 10 by 10 table. This is really easy and something that I hadn't thought about before, but it's totally obvious. Just go ahead and insert tab and then go to the table. And then we want 10 columns. And right here, we're gonna go down. The maximum is 8, but I'm gonna go ahead and, let's see. I'm gonna move this table around. Let's see once this is there. I'm gonna go ahead and just click on this bottom cell here and click the tab key. And that's gonna give me another row. And I'm gonna do it just like this. We wanna make sure that it's a total square. So I'm gonna go up to the table design tab and then the layout tab. Hey, right here is height and width. So let's go ahead and say 5.25. Nice square. Now you can see that waffle chart is taking shape. Let's just make sure that all of the Shading is set correctly, so I'm going to go ahead and click on just this gray, and then I want to make sure that all of the spacing is the exact same. So we're going to go up here to the weight and click on 3. The pen color is going to be 0. Right here on the border tab, I'm going to say all borders, and now you can see a nice waffle grid right here. And if I want to update the colors, I can just click on the cells, the rows, and the columns that I want, and then I'm going to update the shading color that way. Super easy, very easy waffle chart. So that's waffle chart number 2, method number 2. It's a 10 by 10 table inside PowerPoint. Now number 3, we can also build this, of course, with in many different ways with the built-in chart features, but here's kind of an easy way to do it. So I'm gonna go to the insert tab, we're gonna go to chart, and then we're gonna use the stacked column chart here. So I'm right here, I'm gonna say the stacked column, it's this middle option. I'm going to go ahead and just click on OK. And now what I want to do, the source file opens here in Excel. I want to make sure that I have 10 categories and 10 series. So the only thing that I don't need to go ahead and type all of these things. I'm just going to go ahead in this first column and type 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. I'm just going to do this all the way down to row 11 because that will give me 10 cells. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to copy this over. Let's see, there we go, to row K, that's gonna give me 10 series. I'm gonna go ahead and click close. I'm going to, and then you can see here, you can kind of start seeing the waffle chart taking shape. I'm gonna go ahead and delete the title, delete the legend, we don't need that. We don't need the x-axis there, I'm gonna delete that too. Right here, you can see the y-axis is set from 0 all the way to 11, or to 12. We wanna update this to 10, so right-click and format the axis. We're gonna go ahead and update the maximum to 10. And I'm gonna delete the grid lines, I'm gonna delete the axis labels, and what I'm gonna do is make sure that this is a total square. So up in the chart format tab there, chart design tab, format tab is right next to it. We're gonna go ahead and type in, let's see, let's do 6 by 6 so that this is a nice little square. Now what we need to do is update the gap width. So click on any of these series, go to the format data series menu, little bar chart icon, gap width, we're gonna set to 0. That should be nice. And then, and actually what I'm gonna do is probably set this to 5. So we're gonna do 5 there. And I think that might work, or actually maybe not. Let's see what we need to do. No, I'm actually gonna undo that. We're just gonna set this. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna update the fill color to gray. I want them all to be gray. And then we're gonna update the lines, the border, to white. That should be nice. I'm gonna update the thickness of the border to 1.5. And now what we're gonna do is if I push F1, if I highlight another series and push F1 or F4, that's going to copy the formatting that I just did to the last cell, or it should anyway. It doesn't look like it works. Let's see if we do this again. Border, white line, nice. There we go. So right away, just highlight these, push F4, 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 F4. Now I have my borders. Now I want this to be gray, same color gray. So we're gonna keep it that gray right there. Same thing, I can do F4, 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 F4. Nice waffle chart grid right there. Looks pretty nice. Now, it doesn't look like it actually gave me the same weight of the border lines here. So that's kind of interesting. I'm gonna go back down here and see if that's set. No line, 1.5. I wonder if that will work. Nope, it doesn't actually look like it's gonna work. So I'm gonna go ahead and update these to 0.75. That was the default. So I'm gonna update that to 0.75. If I wanted to update the weight for all of them, I think I would just have to do that manually. So you can see this option maybe isn't the greatest option here, but you can color all of these series individually here with the fill color. Say we have 25%. And then if I just want to isolate one box, double click to isolate one single box there. We will update that color. There's this, and there is this. Super cool. So there's three methods to make a waffle chart in PowerPoint. My favorite, honestly, is this method and using that bright side feature to split and align the boxes. Again, it doesn't work if your chart needs to be something that you're updating in a dashboard or a report, but if you just have a single slide and you want to have a waffle chart, you can make this so fast, probably faster than making the chart in Excel or trying to build the chart yourself from scratch. If you like this video, I hope you will give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button, tap the bell, you'll get notified every time I post a new data design tutorial in Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. Remember, you don't have to be a professional designer to look like one with the software you use every single day. I had a great time making this video for you. I hope you had a great time watching it. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next time.